Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to use the plugin Dehancer Pro and make your footage like film. Film emulation is the process of making digital footage look like what's shot and print on film. This plugin has film profiles, film grain, halation and some more options. The best option for using this plugin is node-based. Create 5 nodes and rename it to input. Then, I will create the balance node, contrast node, and in the node number 4, I will put the Dehancer plugin. The last node will be the output node. This is our node structure for this tutorial. On the first node, I will put my input camera space. To do this, I will use the native color space transform tool. Drag it to the node number 1. Here, I need to choose what my camera color space is. My footage was recorded with a red camera, so I will choose the red wide gamut color space. Then, I will choose my input gamma. My input gamma for this footage is red log 3G10. We need to make sure that our color management in the project settings is set correctly for our pipeline. My pipeline for this tutorial will be DaVinci Wide Gamut. In the color management section, I will put my timeline color space as DaVinci Wide Gamut, and for output color space, Rec 709 Gamut 2.4. Back in the color space transform tool, I will convert my footage from red to DaVinci Wide Gamut. So I need to put in output color space DaVinci Wide Gamut and in output gamma DaVinci Intermediate. It's time to search for the Dehancer plugin in the effects library. Drag the Dehancer Pro to node number 4. Inside the Dehancer, I will choose DaVinci Wide Gamut as my source, because I convert my red footage in DaVinci Wide Gamut on node number 1. Inside the plugin, I have a checkbox to enable or disable this effect. I will disable all effects on Dehancer. Just uncheck the enable checkbox. My goal is to start to create something from scratch. In the last node, I will put the color space transform tool. Here, I need to choose DaVinci Wide Gamut in the input color space and in the output color space Rec 709 Gamut 2.4. You can see, if I select the input node and the output node, the conform from log space to Rec 709 is already done. These three nodes right now are not doing anything, even with the plugin. Here, we are going to work on DaVinci Wide Gamut. The color management is very important, so please make sure you set up correctly. Then, I will start with film emulation. Film emulation is the process of making digital footage look like what's shot and print on film. First, I will select the node number 4 to use the Dehancer plugin. I will start with the profile section. The film profile can then be applied to a digital image to simulate the look and feel of shooting with that specific type of film. You can simply scroll down and choose the film profile you want. Personally, I will be using the Kodak Gold 200. You can also use the push and pull tool. Allows you to vary the color contrast look of a scene inside the selected film profile. Then, I like to set up my compensation settings. I will increase my exposure compensation. You can also change the temperature and tint. On Film Developer, I can adjust some controls like contrast boost, gamma correction, color separation, and color boost. I will increase the contrast to make my footage more pop, and then I will increase my saturation on color boost. To emulate the film tonal range, I will use this film compression tool. It lets you fine-tune the light and make your image more soft, looks more analog. You can control the impact, white point, the tonal range and the color density. Personally, I use the impact and the white point to make my highlights more soften. To understand the next tool, I recommend use the Videoscope waveform. Go to the menu in the lower right corner and choose Waveform. Then in the Settings button choose Y for Luminance and disable the Colorize checkbox. If you want, you can expand your Videoscope on this button. The Expand tool provides a separate manual control for the black and white points. I use it to preserve the highlights and shadows. I don't want the shadows or highlights to be crushed. You can see here that the shadows and our light are preserved. So, I use this tool also to control the contrast. On black point, I will drag my shadows. And on white point, I will increase my highlights. This is a great tool to make small adjustments in your footage. Dehancer has developed dedicated print settings that reproduce analog process. The most common print film is Kodak 2383. It has been used in several films. I can adjust the print settings. For example, the white point allows you to adjust the temperature of the print light source, warmer or colder. In my case, I want this more warmer. You can also adjust the exposure. I will open my image. I like to see more detail on shadows. I will drag a little bit more my white point warm. We have the tonal contrast to give more punch or more softness. The color density tool lets you control the saturation, basically reduce or increase the strongest colors. And I can show you an example. On these color bars, if I drag the color density, only the strong colors are reduced. And we have the saturation option. This is the traditional saturation control. If I drag the saturation control, all colors are reduced. This is the difference between the two controls. In my case, I want this more colorful. I will increase these reds and blues with the color density tool. My goal for this look is to make the highlights warm and the shadows bluer. To do this, I will use this subtractive tool. The Subtractive CMY color head changes the color of the light used for the print exposure, and it's a similar method used in the printer lights. I will start by dragging the first option to the yellow side. Next, I will remove the green. To do that, I need to drag it to the magenta side. And I want to add more cyan to reduce the skin's reds and blacks. With these controls, you can intentionally colorize with the different shades in the shadows, midtones or highlights. So my goal is to increase the effect in the highlights and reduce the midtones of the skin tone. Basically, I am going to increase my warmth in the highlights, but I don't want to affect too much my skin tone and my blacks. One of the most powerful tools in this plugin, Film Grain. My personal choice for Film Grain is to remove the grain in the shadows and keep more in the highlights. And this plugin can do that. You can set up the grain between different zones in tonal range. First, I will remove all grain from the shadows. As you can see, all grain is removed here. Then, I want to keep some grain, but not too much, at the skin level. And keep a little bit more in the highlights. This is my goal to film grain. Another powerful tool is the Halation. For me, it is the best way and faster to get a good halation effect. Halation is the film emulation effect, visible as the local red-orange halos around the bright light sources. You can just enable halation and you have a good result. I will recommend this plugin to use the halation effect. A good thing is the flexibility of the plugin. You can make adjustments before the plugin. This is a good option to match different clips and keep your look without changing any settings in the Dehancer node. My recommendation is to set up a look on the Dehancer plugin and make trim exposure adjustments before the node. It's the best way to keep your grid consistent in all clips. If you want to subscribe to Dehancer, you can use the code of DIGITALARTCHANNEL to have 10% discount. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you have any questions, ask me in the comments.